Thank you. early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. Of a big tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. "All is quiet, all is quiet," said the bird gaily. Just then, a duck came waddling around. She was glad that Peter hadn't closed the gate, and she decided to take a nice swim in the deep, round pond in the meadow. Seeing the duck, the little bird flew down upon the grass, settled next to her, and shrugged his shoulders. "What kind of bird are you if you can't fly?" he said. To this, the duck replied, "What kind of bird are you if you can't swim?" and dived into the pond. Argued, the duck swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. It was a cat crawling through the grass. The cat thought, the bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab him. Stealthily she crept towards him on her velvet paws. Shouted Peter, and the bird immediately flew up into the tree. While the duck quacked angrily at the cat. From the middle of the pond, the cat crawled round the tree and thought, is it worth climbing up so high? By the time I get there, the bird will have flown away. Just then, Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone into the meadow. It is a dangerous place. If a wolf should come out of the forest, then what would you do? Peter paid no attention to his grandfather's words. Boys like Peter aren't afraid of wolves. But Grandfather took Peter by the hand, locked the gate, and led him home. No sooner had Peter gone than a big grey wolf came out of the forest.
tree. The duck quacked, and in her excitement, jumped out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer, and nearer, catching up with her. He got her, and with one gulp, he swallowed her. And now this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The bird on the other. Not too close to the cat. And the wolf walked round and round the tree, looking up at them with greedy eyes. In the meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate, watching all that was going on. He ran home, took a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall. One of the branches of the trees around which the wolf was walking stretched out over the wall. Grabbing hold of a branch, Peter lightly climbed over onto the tree. Peter Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle round the wolf's head, only take care he doesn't catch you." Almost touched the wolf's head with his wings, while the wolf snapped angrily from him at this side and that. How the wolf wanted to catch him, but the bird was clever, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso, and carefully letting it down, and down, and down. Caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. But Peter tied the other end of the rope to the tree. And the wolf's jumping only made the rope around his tail tighter and tighter. Came out of the woods. Following the wolf's trail and shooting as they went.
Thank you.
Peter, sitting in the tree, said, "Oh no, don't shoot! Birdie and I have already caught the wolf. Help us take him to the zoo." Just imagine the triumphant procession. Peter at the head. Hunters leading the wolf. Procession came Grandfather and the cat. Grandfather shook his head discontentedly. "Well," he said, "and if Peter hadn't caught Wolf, what then?" And I. Look what we have caught! if one would listen very carefully, one could hear the duck quacking in the wolf's belly because the wolf, in his hurry, had swallowed her alive.